Now, some of the work we have been most proud of to do professionally is the work we get to do with the Neuroencoding Institute and Joseph McClendon III. And he teaches people how to change their identity so they can change their lives. And we're going to share with you some of his best tips today. One of our proudest business accomplishments is what we've been able to do with Squeeze In franchising. The Squeeze In is a breakfast lunch restaurant featuring the best omelets on the planet, and it's been around for almost 50 years, and now you can have a Squeeze In your community. We've seen how this business transformed our families, and now we are so excited to offer this to families around the country to see how this little restaurant might change their family and their community.
If you're wondering how to set up your adult children for legacy and success through a small business, then the Squeeze In is an option we urge you to consider. Come find out more about Squeeze In franchising at squeezein.com.
You're enjoying this episode on Angel Phoenix Productions Podcast Network. To explore our complete lineup of quality programs and media production services, head on over to angelphoenix.com or like our Facebook page at facebook.com/Angel Phoenix Productions.
All right, on today's mini-sode, we are getting to share some of the, I want to do like the vault unlocking. It's not really in a vault, but it is from the Neuroencoding Institute, and it is extremely powerful. As you know, this week we've been talking about identity, this most powerful force in the human personality, this complex soup of different roles and titles and ways that you define yourself, anything that comes after that I am statement as part of your current identity. What Joseph teaches in the Neuroencoding Institute, we learn that we can then construct, if we know that anything that comes after that I am is going to be attached to our identity, we can construct new identities starting with that I am statement.
So the first thing that we do in regards to figuring out who we want to become and what kind of identity we want to shape is to figure out and have a little self-awareness around what our identity is right now. Now, if you haven't listened yet to Monday's episode, go back and listen to the big episode because we give you all the dimensions that you get to think about yourself in regards to your identity and who you want to show up as. But it all begins with some self-awareness. You can't know where you want to go until you know where you are.
Right. So that's exactly why we want to figure out where we are so that we can plot that course in between. But we do need to figure out what that final destination is. What does that look like? And this is usually a fun process for people. And it's also usually a process they don't allow themselves to participate in unless they're in an environment that prompts them to do that. So allow us to prompt you to do that by taking a few moments today or even while you're just listening to figure out what it is that that end goal looks like for you as an identity, as a person, not what it is that you want to achieve, but who is the identity behind that? As we know from Atomic Habits, James Clear says, we shouldn't strive to run a marathon. We should strive to become a marathon runner. So what are those identity markers for you that are in the future that you desire?
And so think about who you need to become in order to achieve what you want to achieve. Who is that person, right? Not the end goal, yay, you made it, trophy, plaque on the wall, $1 million in the bank, but who did you have to become in that process? That's how you start to shape your identity.
Right. If you desire to be a doctor, you have to have an identity as a long-term university medical student before that's going to happen. So thinking about those things can help us figure out what are those maybe even lily pad identities on the way to the big one we're trying to reach for.
So once you figure out where you are, right, you've put your input in Google Maps is where you are. You put your destination input into Google Maps. You have the trail ahead of you and you know where you want to go. The next thing that you need to do in regards to helping you live your new identity is to start seeing yourself in this new identity and living the new identity, even if it means the baby steps. You know you want to be the doctor, but that takes the identity of the student. Now, the student has to take all kinds of actions to even get to being the student in the first place, to then get the student qualification, to then even become the kind of student that then applies for the doctor, who then becomes the doctor at the end of it. And so understanding that we've got to live in this new identity already, see ourselves in the identity so that we feel empowered to take those actions forward.
Right. And so that we can help our brain understand what success looks like and what it's striving for, and being able to visualize, or if you're not a visualized person, that's okay. But can you write it out? Can you write a description? Can you find inspiration from magazines or videos, or go intentionally looking for some images and some statements that can help you construct what that looks like, so that you can really allow yourself to visualize it, so that your brain can say that it's possible, right? And that's what's so powerful, is maybe you can't make the leap to I can be that, but you can let your brain make the leap to it's possible. And if you can get there, then it's so much easier to convince yourself to take some of those actions along the way and live into that new identity, to feel it and to feel like it is in true resonance with who you are.
Now, like any good path, the path to a stronger self-identity is filled with peaks and valleys. So when you find yourself in treacherous terrain, remember to have some compassion for where it is that you are, and to ask yourself, what would my aspired version of me do on this rough terrain? This is a great way for you to start living that future self right now. When you hit the bumpy road, can you act like the person who has already achieved the things that you're seeking to achieve? When the valley comes along, do you carry yourself in the way of that person who you seek to identify as and with that future self for you? So allowing yourself to understand that you're going to face treacherous terrain, and giving yourself the tool of asking yourself, what would future me do if they were in this spot as well?
Stay tuned for tomorrow's mini-sode, where we talk more about this identity formation.
This podcast was a production of Angel Phoenix Productions. Explore more episodes of this show or other great shows on the Angel Phoenix Podcast Network by visiting angelphoenix.com. The views expressed in this show do not necessarily represent those of Angel Phoenix Productions or its advertisers, and may contain language that's unsuitable for younger listeners.